Hey guys, welcome back to another video. My name is Alex, I'm here at Novatech, and today what I want to show you is how to fit a new graphics card in a brand new PC build. So if this is for first time builders, we're also going to go into how to upgrade a graphics card, because there's some finer points to it that if you don't know what you're doing, it can seem a little bit daunting, and we really want to make it easy for you. So follow along step by step as we go into installing a new graphics card, replacing it with an upgrade, and any other supplementary PCI devices you might want to fit in your build. So the first thing what we want to go into is fitting a brand new graphics card in a brand new system. So for first time builders, if you're a little bit hesitant about how this all works, this video should be everything you need to know. So the first thing we want to show you is all the different parts of the card that you kind of want to pay attention to while you're fitting it and how to know that it's going to go in right. So we'll start from the back and work our way up. From the very back, you can see this is what we call the rear I/O. This is the part that faces towards the outside of your machine. And if you look at the thickness along here, compared to one of the PCI spacers that we've removed from the case, you can see it's about twice the size, which makes this a two-slot card. So since we have this as a two-slot card, you're gonna wanna remove two of these. Some cases have these removable PCI slots here. Other cases, you kind of have a bit of metal that you have to bend out of the way and work it until it snaps off, thereby giving you the space you need. So in that instance, just be more careful. Do that before you fit the motherboard, because you don't want any kind of metal components scratching on other metal components. Further down on the card, we have here, this is what we call the PCI interface. This is the part that allows the card to communicate with your system. And then the last part we've got here is what I like to call just a retention foot. This is what goes under the little catch on the PCI slot. So we're gonna go into detail about how it's really important that stays secure so that the card's really in there and won't wiggle around, come out, or God forbid, break. Right, guys, so what I have here is our new gaming capture rig that we're building for future videos, and we need to fit a GPU to this guy. So a couple of things to go into. I've already removed the two PCI spacers next to the X16 slot on the motherboard. And I wanna go into detail about that. If you are fitting a graphics card for a gaming machine, you absolutely need to put the graphics card in the top slot. A lot of budget chipset boards, which are perfectly good, things like your B550s for Ryzen, or the new B660s or H670s for the Intel 12th gen, they might only have a single X16 slot. If you got in really close here, you could see that the pin connections go all the way the length of the slot, whereas down here, the pin connections kind of terminate right about here in the middle. So that's an X8 slot. And there's a whole lot of other stuff that goes into it, PCI 4.0, and the fact that 30 series cards can run at 8X on 4.0. That's not important. What's important, put it in the top slot. Always in the top slot. Right, so we've got our two spacers removed here. We're gonna be putting it into the top slot. Something to always remember before you fit the card, these little retention hooks on the motherboard, always wanna make sure that's already open, ready to go. That's the part that's gonna close over the foot, the retention foot of our graphics card. And again, makes that really nice satisfying click that you get from PC components when you've done it right, so I'll show you that. I like to work my way from the back here in terms of how to eyeball the fit. And so the first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna see these two metal prongs. Pretty much any PCI device is gonna have something like this. And these actually fit in a little notch in your case, between the motherboard and the case. If you look really closely, you might be able to see the two little blank lines where that's all gonna fit inside of there. So as I was saying, I like to start from the back. First thing I'm gonna do is make sure that these two metal prongs are fitting into those grooves in the case as I described earlier. Once that's lined up, I'm then gonna use the space in the PCI slot interface to sort of line up perfectly before I finally go for the pressure and push it in. So if you watch me, it's not too bad. We're just gonna line up those two prongs on our two slot PCI I/O. And you might need to put a little pressure on and wiggle it around. Now I'm slotted in. So now I'm in. I can let go of this card. It's in there, but it's not secured and it's not interfacing. So now comes the part that everybody dreads, where you gotta put a little bit of pressure and just trust. And what you're looking for and listening for is for that hook to close over the retention foot. So just like this, nice click. So, you know, if this was your build, you'd be done. You would just go back and get your PCI screws, and you would just screw those back into place over these two holes right here on the rear I/O, if you can see that. And that would just help keep your graphics card secured. The final thing you would need to do, most motherboards these days can only provide 75 watts of power through the PCI port, so almost all modern graphics cards have some kind of supplementary PCI power connection. Now, because I built this, I've already routed the cables for us, so what I have here is a PCI connector, and you can see the one PCI 6+2 that we need to plug into. So I'll just take that, line up the hook with wherever the groove is, make sure they're all in line, get it all plugged in, make sure that it's completely flush, and that means it's got its supplementary power and it's ready to go. Right, guys, and just like that, that's fitted a graphics card. So this machine is now ready to play games, it's ready to do its job, but unfortunately, this is a game capture rig, and while the 3050 is an excellent entry-level card for esports and 1080p gaming, it's not quite enough. We gotta get that 4K footage for YouTube, you know what I'm saying? So we have to fit today is our 3090 here by Gigabyte. It is a sufficiently bigger card, so I can go into detail about how you fit bigger cards like that. And then we also have our capture card that we need to fit as well. And so that gives you an idea of what it's like to fit multiple PCI devices. And I wanna show you the proper spacing to make sure our card has the right airflow, keeps nice and cold. First thing, we thought it might be helpful to show you guys how to sort of replace a graphics card just in case you're upgrading a system. You already have an old graphics card and you picked up a new one, how to do it. So the first thing you're gonna wanna make sure is that there's nothing still connected to the card. We don't wanna be pulling on anything. We don't wanna cause anything. These are still delicate components, so we wanna take care. So what I like to start off with first is the supplementary power. So the little hook is at the bottom on this one. So I'm just putting my thumb on the hook, giving it a little wiggle, and it should come right out. There you go. So now that's unplugged, we can put that off to the side. The next thing we have to do is that this graphics card is now screwed in on the PCI. So what I have here is just my favorite little Phillips head screwdriver, pretty much the one tool you need to build a PC. And I'm just going to be removing these two screws. You can work with this flat on the table if you'd like. It is certainly easier to see everything. The problem is these PCI screws from some brands, they're rather heavy and easy to drop. And if you drop that on the motherboard, it's never gonna be good, right? It might be fine, but it was never a good thing that that happened. So I like to work vertically in this instance, just so that if my magnetization on my old screwdriver has lost some luster and it's heavy and something falls, it falls away from the delicate components. It falls on the chassis or on the case or the top of the power supply, stuff that can handle the hit. The last part that we've got to make sure is disconnected is the hook over our retention bracket. And this is always a bit of a pain to reach because as you can see with big cards like this, you know, this isn't the hugest card, but it's still big enough that it's blocking part of that hook. Just try to aim as much as you can for the outside. The pressure shouldn't be too bad and just push it that way to sort of let it come loose. So this card is now completely loose. We can give it a couple of little shimmies back and forth, and it comes right out just like that. All right, what I really wanted to show you guys here is the difference in size between these two cards, because what we have here is a 2X 3050, and we are replacing it with a 3X triple slot 3090. If I put it towards the back, you can see that the case of the GPU actually extends past the PCI slot. I think the exact name for something like this could be a 2.5 slot or a 2.9 slot. In these cases, just always round up. If it says it's a 3.5 slot, it's really using up 4 slots. So you just gotta always prepare for that. Some really gigantic graphics cards are out there. And so that's why I wanted to show you what it's like fitting one of these bigger guys. So we've got two devices to fix. We have the 3090 and we have the capture card. Now I don't love this board for this reason, because as you've seen, the 3090 is a big boy. It's a triple slot card, which means all of these spaces are taken. I can still fit our capture card in the next slot down, but it does affect the airflow. If you can, and if this is something you're definitely planning on doing, take a look at the visual specs of the motherboard. Make sure it's got like maybe two extra PCI Express ports and one further to the bottom. That'll just help with airflow a little bit. If this bottom tiny PCI slot was an actual PCIX, so I could fit the capture card there, that's what I'd do. So as you can see, this one has a much shorter PCI bus interface as well. And then it's got the, you can see it's still got the same little retention foot as well, just not connected to the rest of this. So this is a little bit more delicate, but it's a lot lighter and easier to use. So we're gonna fit this guy first. Exact same ruling as before. Don't worry about the fact that it's not filling up the whole slot. It's not supposed to. And just Same rule, always get that nice click. And now that that's in, we're gonna go ahead and fit the graphics card just on top of it, and you'll see what I mean about that gap for airflow in just a minute. And we're gonna go ahead and, just like before, start from the back, line up the grooves for the I/O, line up the PCI, get a good tension on it, and get a click. So as you can see, this gap we've got here is not spectacular. We've got kind of a narrow air channel. Air's still getting in there, and the capture card, while it will emit heat, won't emit a lot of heat, and it's taking up, let's say 1.5 fan slots. So we still have 1.5 fans over here, completely free, breathing easy, and this case does have triple fan intake. So there should be good positive pressure still, and it should still work for us. So everything's in there, we're good to go there. I just wanna make sure everything's secured. So once again, we have to make sure our supplementary power is installed. This card, just to be a bit difficult, has put the hooks on the top. You can see these little notches on the top of the PCI 6.2, and if you can't, we'll just get another shot of it later so you can, because it is helpful to see. And that's just the side that these hooks on the PCI plugs are gonna go into. So I believe I had a cable routed to go like that. So we'll take this one, plug it into the first one, click, and then on this one as well. These PCI plugs, you can see they separate. They're called a 6+2, because 6+2. So some slots have 6, some slots have 8. This is a 3090, so it needs a lot of supplementary power. Just take the +2, hook it onto the one edge so that it's even, the hook's dead in the middle, and then just line it up and plug it all in together. And if it makes that click and that hook goes down and it's flush, that's how you know it's plugged in. I've also got my 3 PCI case screw, or IO slot case screws. I'm gonna screw those in, make sure that the motherboard and the capture card are really secured, because that's just good building practice. Right, guys, well, if you stuck through us throughout the entire video, thanks. A bit of a longer one, went over a lot of good stuff though. Fitting a new graphics card to a new build, replacing old graphics card with old components, fitting new supplementary PCI devices, all sorts of fun things you can do with these as well. There's SSDs that fit into a PCI slot, you got your sound cards, you got network cards, you got these capture cards like this, but let's face it, we're all just interested in the GPU so that we can play our video games. So that's all in there. That's what this machine's about to do, gonna go capture some 4K footage for us. And if you like this video, again, please like, please comment, please subscribe. The feedback we've been getting lately is excellent. It's awesome. Thank you all so much. We're looking forward to more. And any other suggestions, any other questions, just let us know in the comments. We do check them out. Thanks, guys. See you in the next one.